I grew up in Miami in Florida, and my mother used to take me to see Florida Championship Wrestling. And there was one guy in particular that stood out to me more than anyone else, and it was Sweet Brown Sugar. And man, he used to do these leapfrogs. It was just amazing to watch. And cable was something that came later, so I wasn't able to see the programming from up north, but I'll never forget seeing Rocky Johnson and Tony Atlas for the first time. I was blown away by these two guys that were massive, muscular, you know, the drop kicks. Growing up, those were some of the guys that really caught my attention. I've been very fortunate in my career with the WWE. Just coming in the door, I was very lucky to have champions like Booker T take me up under their wing and just give me advice and pull my coat. Teddy Long, Mark Henry, a lot of really good guys that were able to talk to me from the perspective of an African-American in this industry. And basically, they were honest. They said, look, man, it's going to be a little tougher for you. There aren't as many of us, and you know, you're going to have to work a little harder. You can't take any shortcuts, and you're going to have to prove that you're as good as, if not better, than a lot of the other talent. And they all said that they believed in me. They believed that I could do it. It's been 3.5 years now, so I think I'm doing all right. You know, I'm often asked about what it means to me to have an African-American president in the White House. And for years, I said that I didn't believe in my lifetime that I would see one. And it's special because he's not just African-American, exactly like me. He's biracial. His mother's white and his father's black. My mother's white, my father's black. So we have a lot of parallels. It means a lot to me to see somebody who looks like me, who's a lot like me in so many different ways in the White House. I'm sure people told him he could never be president. People that told me I'd never make it to the WWE. Here he is, here I am. So it has a lot of meaning. It was Charles Barkley that said, I'm not a role model. Your parents should be a role model. I used to disagree with him. But now I understand, now more than ever, when you're in the limelight, when you're in the public eye, whether you want to be or not, especially in the WWE universe, there are millions of people watching you. And in our case, we have children all over the world that are watching MVP, that are emulating MVP. I go around the world, and people that don't even speak English, well, they know bowling. And considering the fact that I came from a troubled background, inner city, you know, juvenile detention centers, ultimately prison, I feel that there's a huge responsibility on me to show kids that come from the same background that there is a way out. It doesn't have to be hopeless. You have to figure out what it is you want to do and focus on. Don't let anybody tell you what you can't do. People told me I'd never be in the WWE. People told me I would be dead or in prison before I was 21. Well, they were half right. So I had an obligation to myself to make up for that. I needed my own redemption. And a lot of these kids in the inner city, that's what they need. They need redemption. And if I can be a light, if I can be a beacon, if I can be someone that they can point to and say, MVP did it. MVP's like me. MVP comes from the same place I came from. And look at him now. Then that's a responsibility I'm willing to bear.